The design of this coffee table incorporates a 1x6 to a 4x4 joint. Now, for that joint, we could incorporate 8 dowels. However, that is dramatically overkill, so we're going to use 6 dowels with a space between here and here. Now, we've never done a strength test, or a failure test, I should say, on a 1x6. Usually we've done it with a 1x4, and a lot of people expound their theories on the type of failure and the comparison between the mortise and tenon and the dowel joint. But these people can't expound these theories unless they've actually tested it. Now, we've been testing this system for about 12 years now. And after the initial surprise of the dowel joint being actually 30% stronger than the mortise, we are now used to that. We've tested this dozens of times, and it's all, well, not always, but about 99%. The multiple dowel joint is stronger than the mortise and tenon. And usually what happens is this component here fails along the bottom of the dowels. In actual fact, the dowels don't fail, the joint, the wood fails. Now this is a combination. We're using a 10-ton hydraulic jack here to exert a load against this, which is in actual fact represents this part of the rail or the apron. This part represents a leg. Now, what we are trying to accomplish here is it's a combination shear, oblique, dowel extraction failure. So it's a combination of the two. To do this test, I found that the gauge is not, this gauge goes up to 3,000 pounds per square inch here, but it's not really readily visible. So what I've done is extended the divisions out. This line here represents 1,000 pounds per square inch. This one represents 1,500 pounds per square inch, and this one represents 2,000 pounds per square inch. Remember, that's like close to a ton in load. So now I have no idea what's going on. I suspect that we're going to fail along here, but I don't really know as yet until we actually test it. So now I'm going to use the hand pump to bring up the pressure to the point of failure. That's 500 pounds per square inch, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1,000. Actually, I just failed at just about 1,100 pounds per square inch. And as I mentioned, you can see that the dowel joint has not failed in any way at all. The wood has failed. Now, another thing I'll mention here is that this pressure would have gone higher because this component here should have been a 4x4. So who knows what pressure that may have gone up to before failure occurred.